Hello, welcome to Parivartan India IAS. Today let us discuss the current affairs on 19th December of the Hindu newspaper. Okay, let us look into the first article. First article says Egypt President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi elected for 6 years term. Okay, he is currently the president of Egypt and now he is elected for the second term. He got 89.6 votes. He is a former army chief. And he is ruling this country for a decade. Okay, who is the president of Egypt? Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is elected as the president of Egypt in the recently conducted elections. And let us go to the another news. DGCA approves drone academy at Telangana Agriculture University. Okay, Director General of Civil Aviation has approved a drone academy at Professor Jayashankar, Telangana State Agriculture University. Okay, it is paving a way for remote pilot training organizations. It offering agri drone pilot training to farmers, diploma holders, agriculture graduates and unemployed rural youth. This training is conducted in collaboration with Maruti Drone Tech Private Limited. Okay. Okay, their pilot training course will be provided for 6 days in aspects related to drone piloting. First one is drone piloting, operational safety, risk assessment and crop specific standard operating procedures. Means our government is promoting drones, use of drones in agriculture. So in this they will provide training how to use drones in crops. Specific functions, agriculture specific domain pilot training institute. This is the first of its kind in our country. To that is teaching how to use drones in agriculture. Okay, this is drone training academy at Professor Jayashankar Agriculture University. Next article, the Raman Research Institute here is participating in the first winter expedition in Arctic region. Okay, our Earth Science Minister Kiran Riju has flagged up this expedition. The researchers would examine the frequency of environment in Svalbard region of Arctic in Norway. Okay, Svalbard region of Arctic in Norway. The survey will help astronomers to assess the suitability of located region for carrying out precision astronomy measurement. Okay, for precision astronomy measurement, they are conducting research at Svalbard region in Arctic. One important point to be remembered is that we have a research station in Svalbard, that is Himadri. This is very important. India has a research station in Arctic, that is Himadri. Okay, these four scientists, the team of four scientists from Raman Research Institute will stay in Alsat town of Brougher Peninsula. This is 10-month expedition. This expedition is funded by Ministry of Earth Sciences. Okay, it is funded by Ministry of Earth Sciences and National Center for Polar and Oceanic Research in Goa. It is the nodal agency that is spearheading this expedition. Okay, Raman Research Institute is conducting this expedition. One important news from today is 78 MPs suspended. Opposition calls it a murder of democracy. There is an article in Hindu also. Okay, the protesting MPs were demanding from our Home Minister Amit Shah regarding the security breach in Lok Sabha. Okay, multiple bills were passed in chaos and repeated adjournments. This is a historic high. A total 92 MPs who are from opposition have been suspended. Okay. Unlike in past two Lok Sabhas, there are even the members from ruling party were also suspended. But this is the only time where since 2014 there is a trend where only opposition members are being suspended for far less severe offences. Okay, in parliament, the main functioning of the parliament is to deliberation, discussion, on important matters and seek solutions that affect the citizens. Okay, a thorough deliberation in parliament means we have to utilize parliamentary standing committees and bills for legislation. But multiple attempts were made to browbeat the opposition, where we are disallowing amendments on merit, we are underutilizing the parliamentary committees. There is a criticism on government that they are not sending the bills to parliamentary committees. Okay, that is why these actions, where we are not allowing deliberation, discussions. That is why global research institutes such as VDEM Institute has termed Indian democracy as an electoral autocracy. So it is very bad for our country's reputation. So electoral, they termed it as an electoral autocracy. And we have seen equating dissent with terrorism, misuse of Unlawful Activities Protection Act, UAPA, which has to be used on terrorists, the government frequently using it on dissenters. So it is deliberate equating dissent with terrorism. The present trend is they are equating dissent with terrorism. So that is why US based Freedom House that measures civil political liberties declared India as a partially free country. Not fully free country, it is a partially free country. Okay, one more important news. Advisory to states in detection of new JN1 variant. There is new COVID variant JN1 that is detected in COVID-19 Kerala. Central government is giving directions to conduct revising surveillance strategy to monitor influenza like illness, and center is asking the states to upgrade an integrated health platform portal for detecting early rising trend of cases. Okay, JN1 variant. There is an article in The Hindu that says hollowing out anti-defection. So let us see in detail about anti-defection. Anti-defection means if an elected member gives up his membership of a political party voluntarily. If he votes or abstains from voting in the house contrary to the direction given by the political party. Okay, if an independent member who is elected independently joins political party. If a nominated member joins any political party after the end of 6 months. Okay, for nominated members we have given 6 months time. If they join after 6 months, it will be considered as a defection. But there are some exceptions. If 2/3 members of a party joining another party, it does not come under defection. 2/3 members of a party joins in another political party, it does not come under defection. Okay, any question regarding disqualification under anti-defection is decided by presiding officer. Okay, speaker and chairman. Speaker in Lok Sabha, chairman in Rajya Sabha. Okay, Israel is using starvation as a weapon in Gaza, says Human Rights Watch. Okay, Israel military opened a strike on Jabalia refugee camp in which 90 Palestinians died, and two Christian women who were taking shelter in the they were died. So Pope is saying that Israel using terrorism activities. Okay, UNSC is trying to get a resolution that demands Israel and Hamas to aid and access Palestinian enclaves and that provide Palestinian enclaves to humanitarian aid. UNSC is working on that resolution. In this meanwhile, Israel is attacking 4 Palestinians in the West Bank region also. It increased its attacks in Gaza. In Gaza area, the violence increased to a lot extent. 2.3 million people were displaced. And they are living in shelters where there is no proper water, food, fire. Means basic human needs of them are not fulfilled. So Human Rights Watch is saying that Israel using starvation as a weapon means it is a heinous human crime by blocking delivery of water, food, fuel and grazing in agriculture areas. Okay. What does COP28 mean for cities? We have an article in The Hindu regarding COP28. Recently COP28 meeting Dubai, UAE. Okay, COP28 is a meeting under UNFCCC, UNFCCC, where government discuss how to limit the future climate change. In this, if we look into the highlights, there is a loss and damage fund. Countries have received loss and damage fund. This is able to compensate countries that are grappling with climate changing impacts. Okay, in this, contributions are voluntary contributions, and specific funds are earmarked for least developed countries and small island developing states. Okay, but this fund is under World Bank. Loss and damage fund is under World Bank. It will oversee. Okay, global renewables and energy efficiency pledge. We have to triple the world's installed global renewable energy capacity to at least 11,000 gigawatts by 2030, and we have to double the global average rate of energy efficiency from 2% to 4%. And there is one more declaration to triple the nuclear energy. Now, as we know that nuclear energy is a very clean energy, so we have to triple nuclear energy by 2050. And third is global cooling pledge. 66 national governments have signed this agreement. As per this agreement, we have to reduce cooling related emissions, means emissions from ACs, refrigerators, etc., at least by 68% related to 2022 levels by 2050. Okay, these are the highlights of COP28. With this, let us end the today's current.